guys, this is Retired Dead with the next day in my 31 days of documentary. And I've just finished watching the documentary Roger Corman, Hollywood's Wild Angel, I think it was called. And it's from the mid to late 70s. And directed by, let me see what the guy's name is, Christian Blackwood. If you want to know more, there'll always be IMDB links down below, and also, since this is available on YouTube, I'll put the link down to the YouTube link so you can watch it for yourself. But basically, it's a documentary about Roger Corman, and it doesn't just talk about Roger Corman. It has an emphasis on some of the directors who started off with him, who are now considered some of the greatest directors of all time. You know, we've got Martin Scorsese, Francis Ford Coppola, and then you've got actors like Jack Nicholson, Peter Fonda. Unfortunately, Jack Nicholson's not interviewed in this one. It's not like Corman's World, I think the more recent documentary about Roger Corman, where he was interviewed. But it was really nice to see all these directors that you know back in the day. I mean, Joe Dante looks hilarious. I don't know what it is about. He's got like really long hair and he's wearing a brown shirt with a denim vest on, and it was just fucking awesome. But yeah, it's basically talking about the Roger Corman and his production companies and his history and how popular his films were and how successful some of them were. It was going into his ethic of working at a very low budget and then just capitalizing on themes of the time, especially social subjects, and making highly, highly profitable films. I mean, some of the films he shot were shot in a few days to a few weeks with just a few a few hundred thousand, if that, on some of the budgets, and the turnover was millions. And it was just a really great documentary of a time that is completely long gone. There's no one like Roger Corman, or no one as active as Roger Corman nowadays. Of course, Roger Corman still produces films. We see them on sci-fi with the Sharktopus and things like that. But there's really no one else out there who is making these low-budget films, giving people the opportunities to make these films, and then capitalise on that, almost exploiting the talent to get a really fun and entertaining product out for us film viewers, but at the same time giving these young directors their entry into the business. And they're talking about, I can't remember what year it was, but he was talking about in the documentary about a couple of years earlier at the Oscars, all but one of the people who won awards had worked or started off at some point with Roger Corman. And it's just, even though this is common knowledge, it's still just fascinating to hear that. And what I really liked about this documentary was, is how they were looking at these films as if fans were looking at it, looking back at them now, like saying some of them were crap, some of them were just pure exploitation, some of them were really fun, entertaining. And I find that really good. I don't know why, because you never really consider the films to have that effect at the time, like to have the cult status. But they were talking about them as if they had this cult status for years, and I thought that was a really interesting look. I mean, I'm sure there were cult film fans back in the 70s and 80s, of course there were. But it was just a fascinating documentary. It's all information that you've heard before, but I'm a sucker for anything to do with the 70s. And especially when it comes to documentaries and TV shows and things like that, because I believe this was like a PBS documentary or something like that. But yeah, it's really, really entertaining. And if you're an aspiring filmmaker yourself, then it's definitely one that you could potentially watch and feel really inspired to. And it just shows you that you don't necessarily have to go to film school or be a success right away, or even really be that interested in film as an occupation to be a talented filmmaker. It's all about getting those opportunities, taking them when as soon as you can, and then who knows, you might become an Oscar-nominated filmmaker. So yeah, it works on really a lot of different levels, but it's just a really nice obscurity piece for me, and I really enjoyed it. I could definitely see myself watching this time and time again. So that was my review. I'll put the link down below to the YouTube video that I watched where you can watch it, and I'll also put the link down to the IMDb page to find out a little bit more. And yes, that was my review of Roger Corman, Hollywood's Wild Angel. So, without any further ado, let's see what documentary I'll be reviewing tomorrow. And tomorrow's documentary will be West of Memphis, which I believe was another suggestion from Tattoo Doorman. So of course, go check him out down below as well. So if you have any ideas for documentaries that I could potentially check out, feel free to let me know. If I can source them online or if I have them on DVD, I could put them in the box and potentially pick one out and then give you a shout out. And yeah, if you've seen this documentary, I'd love to hear what you guys think. And until tomorrow, guys, you're all awesome.